Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
I've just received information from Mr. Alpian that he is on the way. He is on a flight now. And then he told me to start the class. And today is Abdul Kahar presentation. It's about syllabus and lesson plan, right? Okay. And now I give time to Abdul Kahar, and I will help you to present your slideshow, yeah. Okay. Okay, you can start now. Okay, can you see the screen?
Yes, I do, sir.
I can see.
Okay.
I can see. Okay.
Okay, you can start now.
Yeah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Okay, today we're going to start with the topic about syllabus and lesson plan. Maybe we can go to next slide, Pak Mahmud. Yeah. Well, for the first time, I will explain to you about a syllabus. A syllabus is an outline and summary of topics to be covered in education or training course. It is descriptive, unlike the prescriptive of specific curriculum. A syllabus may be set out an exam board or prepared by the professor who supervise or control course quality. It may be provided in paper form or online. The syllabus is a contract between faculty members and their students, designed to answer student questions about a course, as well as inform them about what will happen so they fail to the mid-course explanations. It is also a vehicle for expressing accountability and commitment. It was about syllabus, and maybe we can go to next slide about a lesson plan. A lesson plan is a teacher's detailed description of the course of instruction for one class. A daily lesson plan is developed by a teacher to guide class instruction. Details will vary depending on the preference of the teacher, subject being covered, and the need and or curiosity of students. There may be requirement mandate by the school system regarding to the plan. Lesson plan is the teacher's guide for running a particular lesson, and it includes the goals, what the students are supposed to learn, how the goals will be reached, the method, procedure, and way of measuring how well the goal was reached, a test, worth it, homework, and etc. Next. Here, the purpose of syllabus. We have three, the major purpose that a syllabus should serve. The first one is syllabus as a contract. Second is a syllabus as a permanent record. And third is syllabus as a learning tool. Next. A syllabus as a contract makes clear that the rules are set for what is expected to happen during the semester, delegates the responsibilities of student and of the instructor, and also describes appropriate procedure and course policy, and then content required for a syllabus to serve as a contract. that are four kinds of make syllabus as a contract. Maybe next slide. Syllabus as a permanent record serve accountability and documentation functions, contains information useful for evaluation of instructor courses and programs. Next, documents what was covered in a course, at what level, and for what kind of credit useful in a course, equivalency transfer situation, accreditation procedure, and particulation. Next, content required for a syllabus to be useful as a permanent record. Next, Pak Mahmud. And the third, syllabus as a learning tool. Helps students become more effective learners in a course and inform students of the instructor's beliefs about teaching learning and the content area. There are three, focuses on student and what they need to be effective learners. Places the course in context, how it is in the curriculum, how it relates to student lives. And content required for a syllabus that serves as a learning tool for students. Next. Yeah, we're going to the purpose of lesson plan. The purpose of lesson plan. A lesson plan is the instructor roadmap of what students need to learn and how it will be done effectively during the class time. There are four points. The first one is learning objectives, and the second is learning activities. The third, assessment to check for student understanding plan to sequence the lesson in an engaging and meaningful manner. Next slide. Maybe we'll explain about learning objectives. What is it? Yeah, still about lesson plan provides. A lesson plan provides you with a general outline of your teaching goals, learning objective, and means to accomplish them. And is by no means exhaustive. Productive lesson is not one in which everything goes exactly as planned, but one in which both student and instructor learn from each other. You may refer to example of 3-hour lesson plan. There are pictures. The first one is about what must we prepare before the class. And then the second during the class, and then after the class. And maybe you can read the point of before the class, during the class, after the class, what will we do? Next. Identify the learning objectives. Before you plan your lesson, you'll first need to identify the learning objectives for the lesson. A learning objective describes what the learners will know or be able to do after the learning experience rather than what the learners will be exposed to during the instruction. Like in topics, typically it is written in language that easily understood by a student and clearly relate to the program learning outcomes. There is a table below. Contains the characteristic of a clear learning objective. Maybe I will not read it one by one. It's only the simple. We can look it together. There is a clearly stated task about characteristic and description. Important learning goals. You can see that describe the essential rather than trivial learning in the course which a student must achieve. Maybe we can read aloud next time. We're going to the next slide, Mahmud. Here is plan the specific learning activities. Consider the types of objective activities student will need to engage in In order to develop the skill and knowledge required to demonstrate effective learning in the course, learning activities should be directly related to the learning objective of the course and provide experience that will enable students to engage in, practice, and gain feedback of specific progress toward those objectives. Many activities can be used to engage learners. The activity types, what the student is doing, and their example provided below are by no means exhaustive list, but will help you thinking through how best to design and deliver high impact learning experiences for your student in difficult lesson. Next. Here is, we can find a table about activity type, learning activity and description. Yeah, we can read it together. Maybe next slide. Okay, next slide, Mahmud. Yeah, here is assessment to check for student understanding. Assessment to check for student understanding. It involves making decision about, the first is the number and type of assessment tasks that will best enable student to demonstrate learning objective for the lesson. There are two kinds, example of different assessments, formative and summative. And the second point about the criteria and standard that will be used to make assessment judgments. There is one rubrics or checking the writing of the students. Next slide. Yeah, student rules in assessment process. There are two kinds, self-assessment and peer assessment. And then the weighting of individual assessment tasks and the method by which individual test judgments will be combined into a final grade for the course. It is about information about how the various tasks are to be weighed and combined into a overall grade must be provided to students. And the next, there is the provision of feedback. It is important, the important one, because giving feedback to students on how to improve their learning as well as giving feedback to instructor how to refine their teaching. Next slide, Pak Mahmud. Yeah. Plan to sequence the lesson in English and meaningful manner. This is the last slide. Robert Gates proposed in 9 steps. There are 9 steps about a process called on event, on instruction, which is useful for planning the sequence of your lesson using Gaines 9 events in conjunction with Bloom's revised taxonomy of educational objective aids in design engaging and meaningful instruction. We can read it together, gain attention with the pictures, and then inform learner of objectives, prior learning, present content, provide guidance, and then practice, provide feedback, assess performance, and transfer, enhance retention, and transfer to the job. Maybe that's all, Mahmud. We can go to next. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. That's all from me. I give it back the time for the chief of the class, Pak Mahmud. Thank you. Hello.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, Pak. Yeah. For your nice presentation.
Inshallah.
Now we come to discussion. you have any questions to Pak Kahar from Bu Armeida, Bu Bisritawati, and maybe from me, I have a question for you, Pak Kahar. This is only sharing experience, yeah. As we know, you have you manage your own course. I think you have enough experience in arranging your own syllabus and lesson plan. Maybe you can tell us your procedure, your experience in arranging your lesson plan and syllabus for your course, and maybe you can share us example. Thank you.
He left.
He left.
Okay, Pak Mahmud, while waiting for Abdul Kahar, probably I would like to ask syllabus to you and Pak Bu Linda actually, because you are working for the government, right?
Yes.
Abdul Kahar and I, we have the book as for me personally, we have the book as a syllabus, so we just follow the syllabus from the book. But then making the lesson plan itself, it depends on each teacher, right? But what I have learned, we have to approximate the time as well. 5 minutes for warming up, you know, 10 minutes to convey the objective. That is what we do. But what I want to know, I mean, I'm curious because I've never worked for the government. Does government give you the syllables and then you just have to make it as a lesson plan, or how it works in the government school?
Yes, actually we have been given standard EC from the government, and kita diberi ya KI1, KI2, KI3 kalau apa ya, and ada KD, and government stated the kompetensi dasar. Kemudian kita kembangkan itu ke dalam silabus, baru dari pengembangannya juga by the teacher itself, by the teacher
itself. Jadi berarti pemerintah tuh cuman kasih kayak guidelines ya Pak ya, silabusnya dibuat sendiri di sekolah. Oh oke oke oke. Nah, Abdul Kahar is not here yet.
Bukannya syllabus itu diberikan oleh government?
Iya, syllabus dari pemerintah. Tapi kita kembangkan ya, syllabus kan?
Yang dikembangkan dari syllabus itu ya kayak prota, prosem dan sebagainya.
Tapi bukan lesson plan.
Lesson plan itu dari syllabus.
Berarti tahapannya silabus dari government, terus dibikin program, ya. Prosem, dan
and lesson plan.
Oh, berarti lesson plan tuh paling detail ya, di bawah banget. Tapi silabus ya. Itu dari government ya, Ibu ya. Bu Linda. Oke.
Okay. Kalau lesson plan, lesson plan itu kan kita kembangin dari silabus. Nah, yang lesson plan itulah yang bisa kita ikuti dari kembangin guru-guru yang ada sesuai dengan ya
kelasnya, kemampuan anak gitu ya,
gimana sekolahnya, gimana gurunya, gimana komplit alat dan sebagainya. Benar Amut?
Iya. Nah seperti ini contohnya mana tadi, nah ini dia. Kalau ini kan dari pemerintah nih, KI1 ini.
Ya, benar.
Nah, di sini kan kita juga kalau kami juga disuruh mengembangkan di sini, kita tuangkan kegiatan pembelajaran. materi sudah ada di sini, misalnya kompetensi KD 3.1 menerapkan fungsi sosial, struktur teks, dan unsur kebahasaan, interaksi interpersonalisan, unsur bahasan, may I help you. Ini fungsi sosialnya, kegiatan pembelajaran. Nah, di sini, di kegiatan pembelajaran di sini kami juga bisa mengembangkan di sini. Ini silabus ini. Baru nanti dari sini kita lesson plan-nya itu lebih lengkap sampai ke penilaian dan instrumen penilaian.
Okay. Lesson plan itu dibuat per minggu ya, Pak Mahmud ya, sama Bu Lislinda?
Pertemuan.
Kalau kami buatnya per ini, bisa per pertemuan juga yang per KD ya. KD 3.1 ini misalnya beberapa pertemuan itu satu lesson plan. Pertemuan pertama ini materinya. Bisa seperti itu.
Iya, bisa juga.
Oke. Okay.
Oke, okay, thank you Pak Mahmud dan Bu Linda sharing-nya.
Pak Abdul Kahar, mungkin ada pertanyaan untuk Pak Kahar? Mungkin cerita saja mungkin. How do you arrange your syllabus and lesson plan in your course, maybe?
I'm so sorry, guys, because last time, just now, the signal is not too normal. So, what is the questions?
Can you tell us the process, how you arrange your syllabus and lesson plan for your course? Okay.
Depend on my course.
Yes.
Yeah. It's okay. That question is from Kak Arme, isn't it?
No. From Pak Mahmud. From Pak Mahmud, Kahar.
Yeah. For the first time, Pak Mahmud, maybe I'll explain to you about the lesson plan of my school. For my school, I use Gontor curriculum. For Gontor curriculum, every day we must collect what is it about a lesson plan to the name is director of KME in the school. It is for my school, but for my specific courses, as usual, about the lesson plan, maybe you can open the slideshow PowerPoint, Pak Mahmud. Screen scanning. About the lesson plan. No. Yeah, next. Yeah, maybe this is the simple one. I'm so sorry. Maybe I'm so near with the camera. Aduh, berisik gak? Ini lagi di kafe soalnya. Yeah, as usual about my lesson plan when I teach the course, we name it as Iqdad, Al-Iqdadu, preparations. We write down on the paper, about 5 minutes first, when we enter the class, salam, and then greeting, and then explain the lesson before.
and going to the next material and give the question to the student, give motivation, and then closing as usual like that. We don't use what is it, Kementerian Agama syllabus or lesson plan. We don't use it because we use the syllabus and lesson plan of Gontor Islamic Boarding School, because all the books what we use about the school and the course, we use from Gontor Islamic Boarding School, and some book we use for Hello America for the course. Yeah, maybe that's all.
Okay, thank you. So, maybe next question from Bu Amida and Bu Uslinda.
Yeah. Yes, please. Uslinda.
Mau nanya. Sorry. Sekolah pondok ya.
Yes.
Why do you not use Kementerian Agama rules?
Yeah. That's all.
And yeah. Examination. Sorry, past examination. Mm-hmm. You use lulus or tidak lulusnya, use the curriculum.
Yeah, it's okay. I got it, Bu Linda.
Apa ya curriculum? Apa ya maksudnya tuh? Apa namanya, menilainya itu menggunakan kurikulum yang mana, Kak? Apa, menggunakan panduan? Sorry. Menggunakan panduan. Kalau menentukan kelulusan dan tidak kelulusan kalau bukan dari Kementerian Agama pondok, kan?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let me explain it. Actually, for my Islamic boarding school, I say it one more time, the name of Tazaka Islamic Boarding School. Actually, informal, we use the curriculum of Kementerian Agama that you say, informal, in administration. But in real teaching, in the class, we don't use it. We use the curriculum of Gontor. And all the books that Islamic Boarding School Tazaka use is the book from Gontor Islamic Boarding School. But in administration, I mean, we use it. And then maybe Bu Linda confused about UN. Yeah, isn't it? When UN, the questions or the paper question is from... is also from Kementerian Agama, but alhamdulillah, it's still connect. All students are passed. Yes, because of du'a. Maybe. That's it.
So.
Yeah.
You don't even apa sekarang AKM ya?
What?
You do. In your
what
school?
Is it?
AKM.
What is
ANBK?
AKM. ANBK.
AKM enggak sekarang itu namanya.
Yes.
Yes, we do it. Yes.
You do it in your school.
All right. We do.
But pembelajarannya Gontor kurikulum.
Yeah, but Linda, I think Gontor will also I believe Gontor also see the Ministry of Religious Affairs to do the same thing. Only they as you say, you can extend the curriculum, you know, so it won't go too far from that curriculum, but you can create your own books, you can create your own exercise, but still with the same objectives. I think so. Otherwise, if Abdul Kahar said all the students can do the UN, something like that, that means they are going in the same line, right? Even though they don't use the books, but they are going in the same direction. I think, I don't know. Yes, Kahar? Is it like that?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you, Abdul Kahar, for the clear explanation. Maybe Ibu Armeida, any questions?
No, I think because Kahar and I have the informal education, so I think I got a lot of information from him and from you and Boris Indawati. I think I'm good. I'm fine. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Carmen.
I get the information.
Informal class is free. Yeah, Carmen. What we want to do, it's free.
Yeah, but again, we have a guidelines, right? From the book, but we can extend whatever we want. Yes?
Right. That's it.
Misal kalau Kak Armi memang tidak menggunakan deadline in the government, but so far I know though must be to get government line kan?
Yeah, but Abdul Kahar stand aside, right, Linda? They have their own division, English division. So, a little unit, I think. What I got from him is a little unit in the big school, school and English
the
department.
Part of the program, the part of the
only of the part.
Arabic and English. One of the part of the program in my Slavic school. TEC, Belinda. Okay. Because when I present my presentations, Belinda didn't come to the class. Yeah. With
entrepreneur.
You didn't come.
Oh, itu Linda apa?
Pak Nopripal.
Pak Nopripal, ya.
Yeah. Come.
Jadi kan beda pas. Linda, beda Tazaka itu sekolah formal. Nah, ada satu unit di dalam situ, unit informal khusus untuk bahasa. Kayak language center. Jadi beda dia.
Bilingual, nah. Bilingual mungkin tahu di tempatnya Bu Linda. Ada bilingual class.
No, but maybe is kita apa mood? Example mood.
Apa?
Example in Jambi what?
In the government, kalau di government nggak ada lah, Lin.
Nggak ada.
Iya, nggak ada.
Yang
ada di Pak Har tadi itu maksudnya itu dia kurikulum
ya, kursus. Di Jambi sekolah ini yang di mana
mood? Iya. Kursusnya tadi, he talk about his course in his Islamic coding school. That's it.
Oh,
that's it.
Yeah, Linda, yes, Linda. It is in our.